listen, the reason why I'm making this video, okay, is to silence all these people out there that are trying to tell you that whey protein is not real food. And I want to explain something. Just because someone's on YouTube doesn't make them an expert. I don't care if they've got 2 million subscribers. I don't care how many subscribers, how many followers, whatever. Just because they're on YouTube does not make them an expert. And you have all these YouTubers that are anti-supplement warriors. They're like on the anti-whey protein, anti-supplement bandwagon. And they're all telling you, no, don't eat whey protein. It's garbage. It's a scam, blah, blah, blah. First off, let me tell you something, man. This is what I have found with YouTubers. Now, I have a lot of respect for the YouTube community because I know the hustle as a YouTuber. But a lot of YouTubers will tell you a bunch of garbage because they just want the views, okay? So they're trying to plant like mystery or controversy into your thinking so you'll click and watch. Yeah, you're right, dude, whey protein. Listen, dude, let me do you a favor, okay? As the fitness and supplement expert, whatever that you want to take that as, for almost 7 years now, let me do you a favor and explain why not taking whey protein is a huge mistake for you. You're missing out. You're missing out because your homeboy or whoever you follow told you that whey protein's garbage. Listen, nothing is faster digesting than whey protein. I don't care if you don't take whey protein any time of the day. At least take whey protein right after your workout. Of course it's real food. What the heck do you think it is? Freaking powderized plastic? Dude, whey protein, it's real. What you want to do is you want to take whey protein 100% right after workout. It's loaded with BCAAs, more than fish, which is the second best fast digesting protein in my opinion. It's loaded with BCAAs. It's loaded with protein. It's clean. Stop buying into the bull crap, okay? Whey protein is real food, and it's the bomb to drink right after a workout. Sometimes I will drink freaking 3 scoops, like 75 grams of whey protein right after my workout. Sometimes when I wake up in the morning to stop that catabolic state, I drink whey protein. Get that out of your head, all right? One more thing. Listen, I'm gonna throw in one extra little thing for you, okay? Fats. Okay, you're trying to sit there and eat a steak and you're trying to eat chicken and all these fatty items, okay, with your post-workout meal. You don't want fat post-workout, okay? I'm giving this little nugget to you as an added extra. You don't want fat post-workout because fat slows down the absorption of protein. When you get done working out, you are in the most catabolic state possible. That means your muscles are eating themselves alive, okay? And you need something to extinguish that and reverse everything and put you in recovery muscle building mode. What? No. Whether you believe the anabolic window exists or not, doesn't matter. There's one common denominator that we all agree with, and that's you're in a catabolic state and you need to stop that as soon as possible. You need hypertrophy ASAP. Because you listen to your favorite YouTubers out there telling you all this bull crap about whey protein's a scam and you gotta eat real food. Listen, y'all are eating chicken and beef after your workout. Do you know how slow digesting chicken is? Do you know how slow digesting beef is? But don't put something in your body that's not gonna get the job done right away. You can get whey protein around the same price. Now, I wanna interject this right now. Okay, because I don't want you eating slow protein right after you work out. I want you eating whey protein right after you work out. It's gonna hit you the quickest. It's gonna stop the catabolism ASAP. But the price is really around the same, dog. Have you seen the price of fish these days? Sometimes the price of chicken and beef, it's through the roof. Now, backpedaling. I do know people have amino spiked. Again, I think they should be incarcerated. But there's companies out there that will actually post what's called a certificate of analysis, a C of A. And they'll actually put that on their websites where you can actually click and show where it's been tested and proven that yes, it does have this correct amount of whey protein actually per scoop. So guys, I want you to think with your brains. I want you to think outside what people are telling you, and look at science. Okay, look at the real deal. Now, if you are gonna pick out a whey protein, again, go with a company that will post a certificate of analysis, and you always wanna look for cold processed or cold filtered, because yes, heat denatures protein. Heat does denature protein. It burns up protein, rendering it denatured or useless. So if you do get a whey protein, whether it's an isolate or concentrate, make sure, again, you're seeing that it's cold processed or cold filtered. Very, very important. Now, one key thing I'm gonna close with this whole debacle and conundrum that, and stupidity that whey protein is not applicable. I mean, you know, Arnold was slamming protein shakes. I don't think it didn't work for him. But one thing I'm gonna add in there is whether you should use an isolate or a concentrate. Now, isolates are very clean. Isolates, you know, obviously you're not getting a lot of fat, you're not getting a lot of carbs, but they're filtered so hardcore. There's such a scrutinized filtration system with the isolate that you're not getting a lot of the growth factors and immunoglobulins and a lot of the really good things that a concentrate can give you. Plus, a concentrate tastes better. You know, it's up to you. You know, whey protein, isolate will hit you a little bit faster, especially the hydrolyzed, which is like pre-digested. It'll hit you a little bit faster. And, but again, the taste and the growth factors that you can get, and the cost is lower, that you can actually get in the concentrate. I think the concentrate in a lot of choices, in a lot of ways, is a better pick for you. It's a better value for you. That's all I got. If I had a microphone, I'd freaking drop it. Guys, don't forget to subscribe. This is good information, whether you like it or not. Tune in next time.